The following program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.
Hi, this is Ken Gidge, and this is the Out of Politics, the only show of its type whereby one Democrat, two Republicans, it takes two or three Republicans to beat up one Democrat.
He's a legend in his own mind.
You see, he doesn't stop. He doesn't. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ken, it's always a pleasure, Ken.
Introduce our partner.
I do. What happened before I introduce the new representative, I just want to run something by you first.
Why?
Because for the longest time, we brought in senior Republicans to slap you around.
And they have done a terrible job.
Now, what I did was, Nashua sent an outstanding representative.
Who?
I'm going to get to him.
Okay,
to the State House.
Yes.
It's the first term. He's a freshman. So I figured this was deserving to bring Representative Eric Eastman from Nashua on to show you and slap you around.
Well, where is he?
Eric.
Oh.
Eric.
Eric.
Right here.
Eric, how are you?
See how I do that?
How are you, Eric?
Yeah, Eric, right here. It's you
Stealth
can shake
is
my
just
hand.
One
Eric,
of my
never
many
mind
talents.
Him. Never mind him. You're going to be ignoring him most of the show. Okay?
Oh, I'll just give him enough rope to hang.
Yeah, anyway. So
this
ought to be fun. You're from Nashua. What ward?
Ward number one. That's over by the Hollis border.
Who did you beat to become
by a very, very slender margin, I acknowledge. I beat a very capable legislator. Her name is Sylvia Gale, another one named Jan Schmidt, two people that served our ward extremely well for a couple of years, the last couple of years.
So how did you beat them?
Well, were they Democrats, Eric?
Well, they were Democrats.
Okay,
yes.
I have to disagree.
Well, what did they do wrong?
I served with them. I have to disagree.
They voted
for taxes. They voted for gas tax. They voted for Medicaid expansion.
Mm-hmm.
They voted for heating fuel oil. I can say this because I served with them.
You were there.
Okay,
you
to raise.
There.
I was there.
Hold on,
okay.
Ladies.
I've studied their voting record.
He voted for heating what?
The heating fuel oil tax.
What else did they vote for?
25 cents more a gallon.
And they voted
for gas tax.
And what else did they vote for?
No, no rail. We didn't vote on rail.
And they voted for gas tax.
They voted for gas tax.
Isn't our tax down, our gas down to what,
$2
and something?
You know, it's a coincidence. Thank God it went down. What do you think about that on the gas tax?
Excuse me?
Before you go on, I want you to know, he didn't vote for the gas tax, by the way. He voted against it, so, and he's running his mouth.
He voted against it, and so now you're negating that vote?
No. I told
was
them
political.
Why I voted.
That's interesting. A little equivocation here to kick off the show.
Yeah. No,
that's
absolutely
good.
Not.
It was a bunch of BS he gave. Oh, it was political.
Why he said that?
No.
It's true.
Hey, let me ask you, what made you
run? The tax fluctuates.
Well, let's get through one thing at a time.
We never even got to find out why he's a state representative.
The Republicans have as they float along, and nobody but myself stops you guys and
you
says,
cut
stop.
Us off. I was trying to introduce him.
When
find
you say
out why
float along, I need you to be a little more specific.
Yeah.
Because that's a nice dismissal.
You're right. He is a newbie.
That's right.
He is.
And he's very talented, and he knows what he's doing.
But
why did you run?
I'm just waiting
Ignore
for you
him
to
for
make,
a second.
You sound like you have several points. I'm waiting for you to make one.
Point.
I like him.
Make
see?
A general dismissal.
I have no idea what he's talking about.
I do.
Please interpret for me.
I want to find out why he ran.
Maybe it's a
All right, okay. Why did you run? Wait a minute. Wait, you ran before, and you ran as an independent.
I most certainly did,
that
as we were discussing before the
very
show.
Very dumb of you.
Well, we all have to start off dumb.
No, now what? Now, an independent usually is
in fact, I'd
more
rather...
of a liberal. You are a liberal.
No, that's
How
not
did you
true.
Become
that's not
a
true.
Republican?
Well, that's an interesting label to assign to independent. I'm interested what makes you say that, necessarily. An independent, by definition, is indeed independent of both major parties and all of the stereotypes that clothe them. So why you would say that, I don't
and
know.
And if you thought you could win as a Democrat,
why would
you
insult
as a Democrat?
Guess.
He has
Probably
got to think about
not.
It. Yes, he would have.
Ken,
you see, he
why
is,
are you trying to insult
rhino.
Our guest? No, he's
a
oh,
rhino.
Goodness, no.
He's
no,
a
he's
rhino.
Not a rhino.
Yes, he is.
We'll find out on the first few
right,
votes
okay.
here.
No, I did have to think about it. And would you like to know why?
Yeah, go ahead.
Or do you want to change the subject
no, no,
into
no,
the
no,
issue?
No, let's go.
Okay.
Go ahead.
All right. Because a liberty-oriented, civic-minded individual has to take issues one at a time, consider them carefully through the prism of their principles and beliefs. Would you not agree? We all try to do that. I've done that on a lot of social issues, and I've come down on many of them in much the same way as a lot of Democrats do, in terms of the way that
like,
they vote.
For instance,
medical marijuana
Medicaid,
is one example.
Medicaid, you were against Medicaid for
well,
individuals?
That's, well, that's a big statement. Against Medicaid is...
Tito, you got
no, it's not a big statement.
I'm glad you're listening to him because...
You, no.
You
no,
voted
no,
against
no.
it.
Are you talking about Medicaid expansion?
You,
he,
are you talking
he wasn't
about
even
Medicaid
in the house.
Expansion?
He
that's
wasn't
what
even
we're
in
talking
the house.
About.
Well, you didn't say expansion, so...
He's right. There's two different types, Medicaid and then Medicaid.
Are you against Medicaid?
He's a newbie, so
and he knows what he's talking about.
Yeah, and the newbie is that's, asking you for your specificity and not getting it.
He's straightening you out.
Okay.
he just straightened you out this freshman.
I'm waiting for you to frame the debate.
Yeah,
and
he's right.
And I'm still
Medicaid,
waiting.
Medicaid
wait
expansion.
Too, right? I'm dealing with
two different.
Over here.
Have fun.
You are 100% right. Medicaid expansion, two different programs.
Made a broad
one
statement.
One is very low
I'm
income.
Trying to,
the other one there, you can own homes.
I'd love to answer
else.
Your question.
And the sad part is it sounds so Republican. You've got to
again,
him.
Again, there we
he
go.
Is so
he's always with the labels.
I thought I was a rhino.
Talking about, we've been talking about Medicaid expansion, and he says no.
No.
Did you vote for it?
No.
Would you vote for it?
You
was
asked
I in the House?
The question
would you vote
on
for
Medicaid.
It? Would you vote for Medicaid
expansion?
I
voted against it.
I would vote against it.
Why? Yeah, yes. Why?
Why?
That's not a hard question to answer.
No,
it's okay. Let him corner me.
Okay.
Let him corner me.
Okay.
Were you required?
No, because you're trying to set him up
you
there.
Bet I
and
am.
He knows
oh, no,
it.
He absolutely
right.
is.
And
no,
where do you think the show is?
Answer him the question, then. If you want to, don't mind
right,
slapping
okay.
him around.
Right,
I do it all the time.
Batman Robin's got this.
Yeah.
Right, no,
go
right.
get him.
Okay, hold on a second.
Go get him.
Why would I vote against
expansion. Wait a minute.
Can you let him answer the question?
Yeah, please.
61% of the people on Medicaid expansion are women. You are
that's
against
not true.
Women?
Where do you
wow.
come up with this?
You're against women? You're not having insurance?
That's a logical fallacy.
This is the poor people, and you're against it?
You know some.
How can you be against it?
I love your capacity for generating hysteria.
Thank you very
I
much.
I admire it.
Well,
I,
that,
I,
that's the idea.
If I had a hat, I'd doff my hat to your capacity for generating hysteria.
Well,
however,
are you having fun?
Let me answer the question.
It looks like you
well,
are.
Well, he'd vote against it. Okay, tell me why you'd vote against it.
Medicaid expansion is the way that it's designed right now. It's not. It hasn't been carefully considered. It's going to be too costly.
Excuse me.
It hasn't been carefully considered.
No, it hasn't.
It's going to be
he's
too
right.
costly.
He's right. It hasn't.
It has nothing to do with.
It was rammed through.
And so you're also against, obviously,
Look,
Obama.
We need to put on.
Yeah, is that correct?
Slow down.
Is
you
it?
Ask me a question, I'm going to answer it thoroughly. Try to keep it brief.
Well,
however.
Obama, that's exactly what it is.
I didn't support Obamacare.
It's Obamacare.
Obamacare is a government program. You want people on the dole. You know, we want a free country.
Oh,
we want to
give me.
You know, that's what
so
you
do
want.
Do you, by extension, want to equate
give me a break.
Medicaid expansion with Obamacare? That's what you're telling
it's
me.
Right,
correct.
Which is
a yes or no?
That's exactly
right.
what it is.
Okay,
that's
great.
Exactly
it's
what
okay,
it is.
Terrific. Now let us all jump in the Wayback Machine about 4 years ago when that very bill was being discussed in Congress on the Hill.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of back and forth.
Yep.
And it was becoming more and more voluminous,
sure.
and more pages were being added.
Yeah,
yeah.
Pages.
Yeah,
look
is
it up.
Using
right.
words to confuse you?
You know, that's the first time anyone's ever used voluminous.
Okay.
He's
Don't be
used voluminous.
give me a gold star.
Well, you let him.
The fact of the matter. The fact of the matter is.
No.
Can he finish?
He can.
Why do you keep shutting him off?
And why are you guys?
I love getting here.
And why are you guys speaking about a guy who's right in front of you in the third person?
Go get him, Eric.
And he thinks we're not going to do this. Yeah,
can you let him finish?
That man's Robin gets no credit. He's got to earn it. Okay, no. No, you equated it with Obamacare. Now we're going to talk about that.
It is Obamacare.
Okay, great. 4 years ago, what happened with Obamacare? When it was being discussed, there was a single-payer option, which was the main thrust, really the soul of the proposition of the bill.
You're against
Obamacare. You support it?
Did you support Obamacare?
I'm asking you this question. Did you support the single-payer option at that time?
Can you answer the question?
As a voter.
Can you ask him questions?
That did not have to come to us.
No, it didn't.
It's my opinion.
But you asked.
Your elected representatives did have to deal with it.
It didn't come to me.
Yes, it did. Obamacare did. We refused.
Federally.
We refused.
No, you're right.
Locally.
He's absolutely right.
We refused the exchange. The Obamacare exchange, we refused.
Oh, yes, we did.
That was part of it. We made it illegal in New Hampshire.
All the time, and I'm not going to let him get away with it. I don't care if he's
not.
Not going
to let him get away with what? I asked you a question so we could frame the debate about Obamacare.
Why don't you say if I don't have the answer, I don't have to talk about it?
Okay? Because he's 100% right.
Apparently, if he doesn't have the answer, he's just going to pull a bait and switch and throw labels around. How convenient.
Eric, let me talk to you for a second. You weren't there.
Sure, absolutely.
Eric, you weren't there, right? Under O'Brien, we voted
to restore my faith in politicians. I make one reasonable point.
Under Bill O'Brien, we put in a law that we said we will not have a medical insurance exchange here in New Hampshire.
Okay.
Okay, because otherwise businesses would have been taxed and every other thing that went along with this here.
Wait a minute.
I was busy doing what I do, making movies.
No, totally different from the exchange, Medicaid expansion.
Representative Eastman, I'm on Commerce, which is banking and insurance.
Terrific, okay.
And this individual and his party would not let us have an insurance exchange to save money.
That's right.
So an insurance company came along and said, hey, guess what? We'll do
it. Remember I told you he draws out a lot of BS?
You know what the federal government said? Okay, we'll let him do it. So ladies and gentlemen, we're fighting about insurance, and an insurance company comes along because the Republicans wouldn't let us have an insurance exchange, and then they take 10 hospitals out. One of which, by the way, is Nashua. You do know that.
I do.
All right, okay. So they lost jobs, they lost their doctors, and guess what? And then the Republicans turn around and say, well, you know, you lost your doctors, you lost your hospitals, Obamacare, and it's because of you guys.
I can't let you throw the BS out there. Okay, because that had nothing to do with us here, Democrats or Republicans. That had to do with the ACA.
And you want to know something?
That the hot 10 hospitals were going, it didn't happen. One insurance company under Antrim. Don't let them BS you, because I know you know the answers.
What are you talking?
Go after them.
What are you talking about?
You got America. Can you finish our first questions that we asked since he cut you off 9 times?
Oh, well, he did, but he tried to frame the debate. We started with Medicaid expansion. Actually, that wasn't specified. I had to draw that out of him, and we did that. We accomplished that. Then we moved on to Obamacare, which apparently is the same thing. Then we started talking about that and the roots of Obamacare, what made it an effective proposition,
He
already
Obamacare.
Said it he was.
And now we're talking about insurance companies. So which is it?
Are you against Obamacare?
Yes.
You're against Obamacare. Okay, you're against Obamacare?
I voted against it here in New Hampshire.
Why
is
everybody, including the Republicans, you got to get up to speed.
It's a shadow of what it was originally.
You got to get up to speed because everyone, especially federally, is saying we're not going to vote against Obamacare. Mm-hmm. We're going to change parts of it. So guess what? Obamacare is here to stay.
Okay. Well, be that as
it's not going to go anywhere.
Even the majority of the House Democrats agreed that Obamacare, when passed, was a shadow of its former self, a shadow of what it was originally designed to do, and couldn't get passed because it wasn't going to happen.
And guess what?
You know why?
And guess
because
what?
It's a flawed bill. It's loaded. It's Swiss cheese. It's loaded with pitfalls. Loaded with provisos that benefit the private.
And you want to know something?
Eric, okay.
And the Republicans had the opportunity
to make an accurate analysis.
Right. Yes, you did.
And
let me run something.
He's just going to talk to the audience because he can't handle it.
Republicans had an opportunity with Obamacare, and they wouldn't.
Ken, When you're done pontificating and casting aspersions, wait, don't touch me. I'd like to have a logical discussion. When we get around to it, there is a case right now going to the Supreme Court on subsidies.
Uh-huh.
If New Hampshire, by the law, put in an exchange, then what would happen? New Hampshire would have to pick up those subsidies that they give to people with low income that can't afford or that are working.
Oh,
you know, don't stop me now. It's
the
fact.
New
Hampshire would be paying millions of dollars.
Gee.
New Hampshire, where do we get the money from? Who are you going to tax to get more money to cover it?
Answer me the question. Ladies and gentlemen.
Appeal to your audience for help all you like, but do you disagree?
Can you disagree? Yes.
On what basis?
And you want to know why I disagree?
What about the case of the Supreme Court?
Do you know why we're going to have to pay those back?
Why?
Because it was the Republicans who would not let us form an insurance exchange.
No,
and if you want to look that up, you'll see that I'm telling the truth. This is the department I'm in. You guys talk about anything you want to. When it comes to insurance, that's something I know.
Let me talk to Eric again.
There we go.
I'm going to embrace that.
Eric, don't embrace that. Don't embrace that. Because what he's not telling you is the bill never went to commerce. He did never had nothing to do with it. It went to finance.
Imagine
they backdoored commerce because they knew they didn't have
and
the
when
votes
that
in
happened,
don't
Ken,
stop that. Don't stop the phone.
Okay, when that happened, Ken, did you attend those hearings?
I can't
seeing
hear
as you're so passionate about it. Did you attend those hearings?
Part of what he's saying.
Did you or did you not attend the hearings?
Okay.
You seem to care.
Excuse me. I didn't even know there were hearings.
Oh my. It wasn't in the House record. It wasn't in the calendar.
Right.
You know,
it was in there for mining.
I've had all of 5 minutes worth of training, and I know that.
Well, okay, you got 5 minutes. Be around for 6 to 8 years, and you really want to see some really silly things. Hold on, you can keep banging the newbie drum. How long have you been there?
I'm going
five
on my ninth
terms?
Year. I'm on my fifth term. I went to the hearings. I read the calendar. I went to the finance hearings.
Really?
Yes.
So you were conscientious enough.
I was concerned
to actually attend.
Yes, I was concerned because I knew the
exchange. And walk out of there informed.
Exchange would have had, you know, and the government, federal government would have picked up the cost of the exchange, okay?
Mm-hmm.
No big deal. They're right? It's coming from the government. There's a tree out there somewhere where they get that money.
It's magic.
But the other money from the subsidies are the state requirements. That's why it's in the Supreme Court.
No.
This whole thing could be killed soon.
Not.
That's not true.
You
why is the case in Supreme
wrong.
Court?
You're saying it's not on the docket?
Why is it going to Supreme
you
Court?
You have it wrong because every state that does not have a state insurance exchange, the people who have the subsidies could lose them. That's what's going to the Supreme
They're
Court.
They're
going to
lose it,
and
right.
the Republicans didn't know that that was going to happen.
You're right.
And now you're going to make the
no,
state
that's
pay
not true.
For it.
That's not
and
true.
And then you're turning around and you're blaming it on the
honest.
Democrats. You're not going to get
you're
away with that.
You're not being honest.
You're not going to get away with it.
The states that have the exchanges in place, okay, they didn't know they had to pick up the subsidies and the federal government pick up the other costs.
No, you got it. It's completely wrong.
Okay.
Hey,
did you get a chance to go to the governor's? Because you're not getting the truth out of this guy.
Well, no. I'm hearing that a good friend and veteran legislator is being told he's wrong about something that he studied.
Excuse me. How long have you known him?
Well, you claim to be
a couple months.
You claim to be friends.
Yeah, say
I've known him a long time.
He said okay.
Yeah. Watch out for him.
I didn't realize there was a time limit on friends, what qualifies. But be that as it may.
Yeah.
So you're being told you're wrong, even though you attended, you did your homework, and you've been
paying
attention.
Yes,
you
and
didn't
I voted
attend.
Against it.
You're on commerce. I grant that. Obviously, you've done some of your homework.
No,
and
didn't.
Yet he's wrong.
He
blanket
wasn't there.
Statement. What's he wrong about?
The comment was, we've gone about four steps beyond that.
What we're talking about is the
Republicans not letting New Hampshire have an exchange. Mm-hmm. The Republicans have costed the state of New Hampshire and its people lots of money because
an
insurance company
That's
came up
true.
And they took it over.
That's not
and
true.
Now it simply states, which is going to
That's
court.
That's not true.
If Governor, that state does not have the exchange,
out all these insurance companies. We only
they're
going to
lose. That's people not true. Who are in the exchange are going to lose monies, and now you're trying to blame
you're
that on who?
Commerce.
You.
Why can't you
Shame
tell the
you.
Truth? New Hampshire only had Antrim. Medicaid has three companies in Medicaid. Had nothing to do with Medicaid expansion. They did not want nothing to do with the ACA. You're not telling the truth. You're on Commerce. I know more than you do on Commerce. And I don't even sit on Commerce. Wait, I sit on state and federal relations.
I guess this is a new definition of the word, of the, term.
You see what
shame on you.
Ladies and ladies.
Do you see what I'm saying? He's beautiful. I love this guy.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you
what. The Democrats
are
leaving.
He tried to impugn you on something you happen to know about.
And the Democrats believe him. You know that?
Well, that's because when someone says shame on you, they believe that there must be shame to be had.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's a nice test.
Are you guys done yet?
No,
you don't know what you're really talking about.
Does.
Don't take it from him.
That's the thing I don't pretend
you're,
to. I'm asking you to make a point.
You're following him?
I think
am I following?
Don't do that.
Am I following?
For God's sake.
Or
so
am I following anyone? I'm looking for information and stats. He was citing a bunch of them.
If you're looking
you
for
didn't.
Information,
all you said was the insurance exchange was...
Why in the world did you become a Republican if you wanted information?
I think he's pretty sharp there. I think Nashua sent a good guy there versus a tax and spender that we had there.
Oh, the taxes.
That's right. That's what you had.
You know something?
That's who,
I'm not
going to
cast aspersions. I respect anybody who serves.
You've been there, but
Thank
still.
Thank you very much.
But
we
still,
go.
I have to, because for the good of New Hampshire, I have to cast aspersion because they're tax and spenders.
Oh, you're so full of it. You know, ladies and gentlemen, the
full
problem with the Republicans right now, especially here in New Hampshire.
Do you want me to back up what I'm saying?
Here in New Hampshire is this. They don't admit New Hampshire's doing better. They don't admit there's more money coming in.
New Hampshire is doing better.
They don't admit that we can afford a lot more than we could afford before. And a lot more is to take care of those people who can't take care of themselves. And yet, here's a person, a new person, who says, oh, no, we don't need Medicaid expansion.
Ask them why New Hampshire's doing better.
The people who can't afford insurance. Hey, guess what? It's cold outside. You think anybody's losing their heating?
You want to ask them? You want me? With
anybody
you.
Losing their heating?
You want
a lot of people?
That's
a lot
right.
of people. A lot of people can't afford it. Okay, so what are you guys doing about it? Oh, wait a minute. You took money away from that.
No, we didn't.
You didn't.
No, we didn't. We put money in it.
You want to know something?
You want to know something?
Oh, yes.
First
you took
all,
it away, and then you,
you
put it back in.
You know, step back for a second.
Okay. No, that's a big
you know
statement.
I'm curious
about how that happened.
Let me run something by you.
Here we go.
Your budget here was 7.5%. The House budget was 7.5-8% spending above. The governors, they totally didn't even support the governor's budget. It went to the Senate. The Senate only raised the O'Brien budget $500,000. And they divvied money in different other line numbers there. The reason why we have a surplus is because it's a Republican budget.
Okay, hold on a second.
Let's see what I'm saying?
Let's get something
They'll
straight.
They'll never say that.
The reason why O'Brien balanced the budget...
Yeah, it had a surplus.
He took money away from hospitals that were paying money.
No, he didn't.
Of which we were supposed to give it back as we have in
the last
20 years.
That's illegal. What don't you understand?
That's
illegal.
He wouldn't give the money back.
O'Brien fixed the hospital thing.
And the hospital
sued. It was illegal
what we were doing. And it cost us how many millions of dollars?
That was Metascam.
$300 million.
What don't you understand?
So he did not.
Medicaid scam went on for years.
Where is O'Brien anyway? Shame on him. He's not here.
Under Republicans and Democrats. Governors, Medicaid scam went on for years. O'Brien seen this winning because there was a Medicaid audit. They said it was illegal for us to take money, tax them, which is that's legal to tax the beds, but it's illegal to bring it in and give it back after the federal government gives us money. That's illegal.
No, sir. That's not
certainly
what, that's
illegal
not what
to
it was.
Me.
Smoke and mirrors.
You want to know why it was illegal? What it was illegal is because if we and of course
and
the Republicans wouldn't
you're
won't
on
tell
commerce.
You this. You know what Republicans did
this.
By doing what O'Brien did. It went, by the way, it was a Republican who started this. By doing what O'Brien
did, you notice I said Republicans
somebody
and
said,
Democrats.
Oh, no, you're not going to give us money back.
You did hear that, right?
So guess what? The hospital sued, and you know what they came out? And this is the Republicans. Tax, spend, big spenders, horrible people, the Democrats. You know what we have
He's
to do now?
He's not being truthful. They didn't get $300 million. There was a settlement.
We have to tax more people to continue getting that money. How's that?
There was a settlement.
Shame on you.
There was a settlement. He's not telling the truth. The Supreme Court never answered on it. okay? Just like we passed a law on low-income kids to be able to go to private schools like someone else, other kids with deep pockets, parents. The Democrats took us to court and didn't want that. They said, oh, no, we don't want them going to religious school. That's businesses making donations and getting a tax credit.
You
see the type of people they are?
You know, this sounds really nice,
can
but
we
the,
let our
the
guests
problem on? Is you hey, have local
it's just,
school
it's
systems
diff- it's the difference
that
in fundamental
cannot
worldviews.
Afford, can afford, cannot can, having enough can, money
can
to
the
run the schools,
smart.
And they want to put them in private
can
schools.
A lot of Nashua
Gee
kids,
whiz.
A lot of Nashua kids are taking advantage of it, so I'd be careful there.
Yeah.
Can we let Ken? Can we let Eric
this
speak?
This is where the show gets good. I got him confused.
Can we let our guests have some?
No.
To say something.
Well,
yeah?
As long as he's
well,
sensible.
Evidently,
you speak too slow. You got to speak faster.
Oh, really?
The show, yeah.
Did I?
It started off slow. But
is it volume or speed? It sounds to me more like volume.
It's called
and gesticulations.
There's another
time word.
Turn it on. You're not going to turn it off.
He throws everything out there without fact.
What is fact got to do with anything with politicians? What's wrong with you guys?
Exactly.
You think this is something?
I am an elected official.
What?
Yes, because if I was a politician,
you're elected.
I would have to
you
tell people
me.
What they want to hear. I would have to give them the BS just so I can get a vote. I tell people like it is. I look them in the eye, good or bad, when they ask me.
How many
question.
Democrats are in your wards or in your area?
Oh, I don't know how many Democrats. I know I'm. I come
Excuse
out number
me. How
one.
Many elected Democrats?
Oh, none.
None. So let me see if
there
I have
was
this
one,
straight.
But we knocked.
He's
her
in a completely total Republican area, and he wins as a Republican, and he thinks everybody loves him. They don't love him. Look at him.
I'm a lovable guy.
This? Well, his wife loves him.
That's an interesting theory, but that
an
doesn't
angel.
Speak for my circumstances. I was obviously elected in a district.
Well, you're almost as homely as I am.
I'm interested in hearing what he just said. You say that again?
Yeah. There are a lot of people that like to theorize that the state's a so-called purple state. I think that if that's true, then my district is emblematic of that idea. There's a big mix, ideological, political mix in my area. People have all kinds of lively discussions and beliefs. There were 3 Democrats in my ward sent to Concord last term.
Yeah.
Or during the last biennium.
Yes.
Now there are 3 Republicans.
So what does that mean? What do you think? Why?
Obviously
people are very, very frustrated with what's not only going on in Washington, what's been happening in Concord.
And,
you went door to door?
You're right. Ladies and gentlemen.
Can you let him finish? You cut him off again. Can you let him finish?
Well, I'm pointing at the camera.
Well,
okay.
When he's,
let me hold my point
when he's,
there.
When he's, when he's losing a point, he turns to his lifeline,
right.
Which apparently is the listening.
Yeah, nobody. The camera's the only one that listens to him when we don't. But you were saying, you went door to door.
Well,
what
things have
think?
Changed. There's a real sea change, and that's evidenced in the way that
why
winds
is there a
blow.
Change?
Well, let him finish. He's trying to.
I'm not wait. He
that's,
said he's
that's evidenced
change.
In the way the winds
change.
Were blowing this
okay.
midterm election.
So they were
obviously.
Not happy with what?
The Democrats.
No, they were not happy with what?
The Democrats.
Politics in general.
Well, nobody's happy with politics in
okay,
general.
Okay, no one's happy with politics.
I don't think that's what turned
have
the seesaw.
Been the Republicans.
No, the Democrats. Let me try it again.
Oh, I
that's
see.
That's why they voted this back in.
They voted you back in?
Yeah, they voted the Republicans to take
Why
back over the House.
Why is it, if it's a Republican or a Democrat, midterm elections, the party always takes more seats? This is what happened.
Okay.
This is why you're there.
Then,
I'm sorry
you know,
to say.
Some,
you think you're a good guy? You probably are.
No, I'm aware that the seas changed and
that, exactly.
that's how things happen.
But if he does
I'm
a good job.
Exactly. But the fact is, I ran as an independent 2 years ago.
Yeah, that's right.
You
so
know
yeah.
that.
How'd that
and
work
you,
out?
Well, terribly, obviously.
Terrible.
We
but
both
he
know
name,
that.
That gave name recognition.
It gave me name recognition, but there was a reason, a philosophical reason I did it. It was the same reason I did it this time, too, and my politics haven't changed one iota.
I don't believe that you're a Republican. I just told he's a rhino.
I don't think
hiding.
So.
I'm not.
He's smart.
Why are you insulting our guests?
He's a smart guy.
Why are you insulting our guests?
Because he's an artist.
You've seen me.
Yeah, I have. You're
in
a Liberty
Concord,
guy. You're
for months
right.
going through orientation,
That's
orientation
right.
training.
Yes.
We've had discussions.
We sure have.
And
I see you as a Liberty candidate. I see you want to keep your hands out of the taxpayers'
pocket.
That's
an important
pocket.
Word. I'm
That's
glad
right.
you used mm-hmm. it. I'm glad you're calling it into question. So go ahead and disparage it all you want.
Ultra,
ask him how he voted on the guns in the House.
Ultra Republican hate Democrats. I'm just so sick. I'm so
That's another
sick.
Big statement.
I'm so sick of these Republicans getting into these organizations. You know what we ought to do? We ought to get a, if we could, we'd put it on the, put it right on the screen, exactly what the Republicans are saying about the Democrats. It's awful.
Right,
and you're for Huckabee.
No, I'm not. Wait, I don't know.
I thought
who.
You said you're for Huckabee.
No, you didn't
okay,
hear
when
me.
We do that, the
you,
other
now,
side
see,
of the screen should display what the Democrats are saying about the Republicans going down on the ticket.
I said I was
for Huckabee?
Mike Huckabee.
No, you're not. Okay.
You didn't,
good for you.
See, you didn't listen to me when I said.
You should look at what the Democrats are saying about the Republicans during this last election cycle.
When Rick Perry ran, because
Perry,
I supported
Perry.
Rick Perry.
So
Rick Perry had the fires going on.
Why do you like Huckabee?
I like Huckabee because...
Why do you like Huckabee?
You don't even let us
I didn't
answer.
Even confirm whether
he
I do or
like
not.
He doesn't like Huckabee. See?
He nope. has not taken a position.
He's a Democrat.
I neither confirmed nor denied it, Ken.
Do you know why he's a, I know
Ken?
He's a Democrat? Because he's an honest.
Ken, because you're leaping to conclusions.
No,
when you're done, we can have a conversation.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's not an honest.
When you have governors that are successful and they've done great things with their budget and they kept their hands out of the taxpayers' pockets and they believe in smaller government, they believe in letting people do their, you know, thing and freedom and liberty, hunting and fishing, and go out there and teach people to fish so they can eat.
You know what? I was just thinking there should be a theme song right now.
And
I
don't want to hear that.
That's exactly.
Because they want big government.
Wait.
Government has the answers with the Democrats.
Do you realize,
that's the way to go.
Yeah. The Texas governor
call
gave
the nanny.
Everyone.
That's right.
Let the nanny do everything.
Fish hook. Go out and go fishing.
If you teach people,
when's the last time you
survive,
did that?
How to fish?
Yeah, sure.
How to hunt? They'll eat forever.
What do you mean? I go fishing every week when I'm in.
See, many of you Democrats want to eat off the government.
Oh.
You all do. Look at under Obama.
And you're against unions.
No, it's not that I'm against unions. I'm against forcing
unions
people.
Unions are the best thing in the world. Did I hear that right?
Ken? I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to him.
Yeah, but I'm sitting right in front of you. So
it's not that I'm against unions.
I'm sorry that you went
I'm against forcing people to take money, make them pay dues, to work at a company. I'm against that.
Oh.
I think unions done a great job.
Now, there's an important point he just made there. I'm gonna call it out. Operative word in that sentence was the word make.
Right.
To compel. Okay?
Don't confuse
I think that's the discussion.
Okay.
It's not unions are good or bad.
You want to know what the Republicans don't want? Oh, wait a minute. You're a Republican. You don't want, he doesn't want this either.
No, what I am
does not want to,
is a legislator.
Talk to us.
Never mind my title or what you want to...
Ladies and gentlemen,
what you
if
want to call it.
A union does not take dues, will not accept dues, or a person says they don't have to pay dues, the Republicans will not make a bill that simply states if a union gets, let's say, a raise, everyone has to get the same raise if they're in the union or not. And that's how they try to break
it. Don't have
unions.
To happen that way.
That's how you
that don't happen that way.
You know,
that characterization
sounds like a diversion.
That's
I don't think he characterized our take on unions.
No, he did. That
was a diversion.
That's right.
Am I right?
Yes, you're right.
Oh, okay.
Right.
So in other words, if you do not pay union, okay, and a union gets a raise, are you going to get a raise? Are you going to get a raise?
No. No.
I choose not to belong to a union, my friend.
Are going to get a raise.
Will you let me answer something, first of all? When I retired,
and that's the reason why the Republicans
when I retired from the Marine Corps, I went into the staffing business. When I retired, will you let me finish now?
Yes, go ahead.
When I retired from the Marine Corps, I went into the staffing industry. Okay?
Staff?
Staffing. Okay? I was a headhunter. I was a national recruiter.
Take that.
Okay. Now, let me finish now.
Ready? Come on.
Let me finish.
Okay.
So what happened is I used to go and hire people for different companies. Okay? They negotiated themselves. So these people in these companies get hired. Like, for instance, my wife, Lexington. She's my wife's an IT guru. I call her the big geek.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? She's a GIS administrator. She got interviewed for a job. It's a new position. They hired her. Next thing you know, a month later, the union's coming after. Oh, we're a union in Lexington. Oh, you got to join the union. My wife said, why? You didn't do it. I negotiated my salary. I did everything. Now she has to pay the union every week out of her salary. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's extortion.
Right. It is. She's forced to pay.
All right, okay.
They didn't negotiate her money.
And I love the way
benefits.
They say that. They say that this is extortion. But they will not let the politicians who say they don't want you.
Once again, I'm not a politician.
They will,
but that's not
me. You're
not
a politician.
I'm not a politician.
He's been elected six times.
But,
what do you
but
think
I don't kiss people's butt
but
to get a vote.
But you want to know something? If you pass a law simply stating if you don't want to join a union, okay, but if you don't join the union, you do not get the raise and you do not get the benefits that the union has. They won't pass that, so the unions say, oh, hold on a second. If they're going to get what we're going to
get them, are we a free country?
Them,
wait,
guess what?
Do, you do we live in a free country?
Is that an accurate?
No, yes, he's not accurate.
That is,
no,
that is position on unions.
That is
no,
true.
I wasn't there.
No,
that
that's,
is,
it, that's
that is absolutely
okay.
True.
All right.
What comes out of his mouth, he's a legend in his own mind. So,
well,
you know
that's,
what I mean?
So I think we all are.
Yeah.
So that said.
An honest. He's an honest again. I know it. Talking about art, let's change it a little. Let's talk about something we won't have to argue about so much.
Not a bad idea.
Let's talk about murdering. Let's talk about here's the pen, here's the gun. What took place in Paris?
Oh, what a shame.
What was it? Two brothers
here,
walked
into a newspaper
that does cartoons that the jihadists
they
don't
do,
like.
They have a magazine.
They walked in and they killed
and they just
six
mowed them
or
down.
Eight, mowed them
Nine,
down.
Yeah.
They finally got him last night. Okay, is the pen stronger or more powerful than the gun?
Okay, that's a non sequitur, but what are you actually asking
me?
This bad thing happened.
What is more important?
The pen means freedom of speech.
Okay,
so.
All right, well, what do you, he's an honest. He doesn't know that.
The pen.
You don't have to get.
And I'm waiting for you to done ranting.
Yeah, well, I'm trying to figure out what he's trying to say.
You framed this heinous situation, then you asked us a non sequitur question.
Then you brought up a pen.
Yeah, a pen.
Okay, that you're scribbling.
Okay, were you going to ask me about guns, or were you going to ask me about pens?
No. We're going to talk about. Let us talk. I'm trying to find out.
Why does it take us 20 minutes to talk about Paris?
The freedom.
Or are you coining a cliche?
That we possess. All right. Is very important.
Okay.
What took place in Paris?
Could happen here.
Well,
it could happen here.
Can you stop?
Okay, but go ahead.
We know that.
Let me hear the question.
I don't want a referee here. We don't need a referee.
No, I want to hear the question.
Jump at any time because he does it to us.
He's the referee. Now we got a referee. No.
Oh, yeah? I just got off a film set I directed.
He is an artist.
Get used to it.
He's an artist, all right? So being an artist, look, he does films, okay?
Okay.
Look.
So he knows how to reach all your BS. Okay, good.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Pretty much. We might have to talk about your character here. It's not selling.
He does have a face. Would you say he does have a face for radio?
I have to talk because these guys can't even handle themselves.
Eric, he does have a face for radio, don't he?
Talking about themselves. I know. I do have a face for radio. Yeah. I agree.
Yeah, that's
in radio.
No
can
comment.
We get back to Paris here? Those poor people.
A second is a long time.
You know something?
In
you've been
TV,
trying to duck around the First Amendment. You've been ducking around the First Amendment on Paris. You've been using a pen. You brought up the guns.
They died because
they were determined not to stop
the
First Amendment.
I just want to know where you were going with that. So tell me where you were going
on
with that.
On freedoms.
Well, the freedom of what is more powerful? Is it the gun or is it the pen?
Well, of course, the gun is,
which is more powerful?
The person is.
Excuse me?
The person
the
behind the gun.
The Declaration of the United States. Do you have a Declaration of the United States on you?
Come on, let's see. Right here.
All right, okay.
No, you probably never even had one of these.
We,
in
the people.
I've got an answer for you, Ken, if you'd like
it. See this? It rolled that, and that's our freedom.
Right. But see.
So what's more important?
Okay, well, this is a result of a pen.
That's right.
Here's how it goes. Pen box. I got a pen. Didn't work. Soap box. Doesn't work. Ballot box. Doesn't work. Ammo box. That's usually the progression of events.
So, that's right. Blood.
What does that
blood
got to
was
do?
Shed for what the freedoms
that?
We
so
enjoy.
So are you saying that the people who killed all those people did all those things?
What I'm saying
did
is
all those things?
The people that did that.
So
the people who killed all those people. You're talking about Paris?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we've been talking about.
No, you changed
the subject. No, you changed the subject about 29 times.
What year? Well, of course. That's the idea.
Marty, get my wayback machine.
He's done radio before. He's used to changing this guy. You know? That's why he really
all right. Okay. Let's be serious, though.
I'm disgusted over what happened.
Your opinion about what took place in Paris 60 seconds or less.
No, it's a heinous event, and are you asking me what new regulations or laws they should enact in order to respond to it?
No.
Or what?
No. Well, it was an awful thing that took place,
naturally,
correct?
Of course it is. That's how can we
You're
not
an artist. You want to have the freedom of speech. They're
naturally.
Artists. And,
naturally.
And people walked in.
Yeah. Right. No, you don't you don't quash the freedom of speech, the freedom of
expression. Matter of fact, that
it's fundamental.
Yeah.
That director did
freedom to defend yourself and the freedom to express yourself are fundamental.
You watch Charlie Rose?
Occasionally, yeah.
Last night he had somebody on, and the guy quite simply said, you want to know something? I don't like people burning flags. He says, but I will fight for the individual to burn that flag.
Yep, I agree.
He says, and that's the difference. Mm-hmm. These people are writing cartoons about Muhammad. And guess what? Muhammad obviously was a prophet, mm-hmm. all right? We understand that. In fact, he liked Jesus. He thought Jesus was... If he could see what his people are using to kill people
jihadists
over religion
and everything else, that's right, it's
is
crazy.
Really dumb.
You know,
that's stupid.
Many countries there utilize, they were always after the Christians. They were always doing cartoons or this or that. But you know something? We're not taking to the streets. We're not murdering. We're not, you know, just, we believe in freedom
of
speech.
Sadly, we've had our moments in Christianity where we were not nice people.
Clearly.
Okay, we're in 2014, okay? So we're talking here, you know, in the American way.
That's right.
He likes to go back in many, many years, and he can't back himself up, he says.
Would you agree that's
probably where they are? Every large group of people and every large group of people that have a doctrine have skeletons.
That's right. Over the years, we've changed and gotten, you know, civilized and learned to, like, respect each other, and that's where the Constitution came
in. I think we're still the same human animal, but I think one of the giant leaps forward that took place in within the last few hundred years was when democracy was really given the real test drive it deserved.
Right.
You know?
No, I agree.
And that's why we're here having this
conversation.
Look
at him. He's all confused. He's trying to get in here, and he don't know how to handle you because he wants that big government stuff.
Last time I checked, democracy is buying for the people. So, you know, hence the term Democrats, people that want the popular vote to be a centerpiece of the way that we do business in government. Am I right?
Your point is what?
He just
we occupy.
What is his point?
We occupy a society that has been defined by a big government.
This person does not like Huckabee.
No,
he doesn't like Huckabee.
No,
I didn't.
You didn't.
You put those words in my mouth.
He likes Huckabee.
Actually, I declined to answer you.
You never even let me finish about Huckabee. You know, it's a shame. You cut me off over and over on that. You know. I told you earlier. I have a tough decision there: Huckabee or Perry. But both of them done great things as governors.
Excuse me.
You want to vote?
Do
you like Hillary?
Do
you like Hillary? Do you like Hillary?
Have
you
ever watched it?
Huh?
I was a Ron Paul guy and still kind of am.
Do you like Hillary?
Yeah.
Ken.
Oh.
Ken.
There we go.
Ken, do you like Hillary?
Let's have this. No, not this.
Ken, stop changing this. Do you like Hillary?
Very important information.
Okay, so you don't care that she dropped the ball on the veterans and the ambassador in Benghazi? And all the emails that are coming out there.
And people turn up dead on park benches.
That's right. You don't care about that? You don't care about she's married to a guy, I mean, that she should have got rid of on rape and been accused and bought off women? You don't care about that?
He was not accused of rape.
No, yeah, he was.
He was not accused of rape.
Okay, he wasn't.
And so...
Let me bring it up? You want me to tell you exactly who?
All right, we're talking...
Do you want me to do a fact check?
No.
Okay, I didn't think so.
We're talking about a woman... whose husband had multiple affairs.
That's right.
She was a first lady when it came out. She decided as a true woman or man who can forgive the woman or man
right.
to move on.
That's right.
That is,
yeah, that's
guess
your right.
what?
Keep that's
the
your right.
family together, and not only that,
that's your right.
keep the country together.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, this was a very strong, and then mm-hmm. Secretary of State for 4 years.
Yeah, and look at her record.
And look what she did. She was incredible.
Who was the guy that committed suicide under Clinton in the office there?
I do too.
Yeah. In the park.
Well, supposedly committed suicide.
Right. Yeah, you're right.
He was completely
Hillary
depressed.
Will never ever be president because
be
he'll be like John Kerry. She'll be swift boated.
What?
She'll be like John Kerry. She'll be swift boated over Benghazi.
There
that was a
we
disgrace.
Go, ladies and gentlemen. You have heard it
you
right
heard
here.
It right
well, that's
me.
Just one of many examples, Ken.
What he's saying is you don't think Kerry was a good soldier?
No. What veteran?
Excuse me. He was
what veteran
not
turns his back
a good
on
soldier.
That's right.
Who goes to Vietnam with a camera?
Wait a minute.
That's right.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
He was like Gene Fonda.
Wasn't he a veteran? Shame on you.
No, shame on you.
Especially being a veteran. And you want to know something?
He was a disgrace. He wrote up his own medals.
You weren't even alive for the
Vietnam War. His medals came in later.
How come? Shame on you.
He does look young.
One thing I'm really pissed off about right now, ladies and gentlemen, is when anyone talks bad about Kerry, shame on you.
Thank you.
Shame on you.
I served my country 22 years.
So he made a point about Kerry. Tell me why that point was false.
I got a question. And you know who did that?
Did you ever serve?
You know who did that?
Did you serve?
You know who did that?
Did you
Bush
serve?
Bush did that. And
did
you, know
you shed any
and,
blood?
And what did he do? And what did he do
Wait,
to McCain?
You see, we go to...
Did he do the same thing to McCain?
Did you ever...
McCain was a bad soldier?
Did you ever shed
shame
blood?
Shame on you.
Did you ever shed
shame
blood?
Shame on these soldiers.
Did you ever shed
shame.
Blood? He turned his back on the Vietnam
excuse,
veterans that were on the battlefield.
And so did
he
McCain.
Sold them out.
McCain
no, John McCain.
Awful.
No, John he McCain.
Was, well, I mean, this is what... Excuse
John,
me.
How was McCain awful?
The tell me how he was awful.
The same,
tell
the
us.
Same,
I'm hearing this
yeah.
stuff.
How was he awful?
The
tell
same,
me how. No, wait.
These are great
you made a comment.
You're
tell
giving me
how
a lot of ideas
no,
for a lot of great
tell
movies.
Tell me how McCain was awful.
You sure are.
Tell me how McCain was awful.
Outside of the contract now.
You made a comment. Tell me how McCain was awful.
It's fiction.
What did McCain do? What did McCain do?
Are you a notary?
Okay.
What did McCain
do? We can't need a notary. He's giving me some great movie ideas, ladies and gentlemen.
What did McCain do? Tell me
of course, this is all fiction, right?
Yes.
Everything I'm hearing coming out of you.
No point.
What did McCain do? Tell me what McCain did that was awful. He was a prisoner of war. He came back. He stayed in the military. Tell me what he did. He was awful.
I have no idea the point he's making. What did he do wrong?
Wasn't the same people who went after McCain go after Kerry?
No.
Oh, wait a minute. Well, no. And that was Bush.
He had, no.
And right on stage.
Not about the military. Not about his military
stood up
service.
And said how bad of a soldier McCain was.
No, no, I never heard that.
People came
forth. I never
forth,
even heard that.
And it's the
where are you coming
people.
Up with this?
A, how much you want to bet?
You know,
how
you make you this stuff
bet?
Up?
When I run into writer's block as a screenplay writer, I'm calling Ken because he's got some great stuff.
Yeah, he does.
This is really
I don't know where you come
stuff.
Up with this stuff. I've never so ever.
This is
how much
of,
you want to bet?
There's a lot of
hooks.
Bring it up. You owe
how
me a lunch. I'll bet you the lunch you owe me.
No, yeah,
you're
going to
lose your
I'll
pen.
I'll bet you the lunch
you owe me.
I'll tell you what. Where's
you
my
me a lunch.
I wanna, where's my, what did they do with
yeah.
it? Did they take it away from me?
Yeah, they took it away from you. You're dangerous.
Yeah, look, I'm
what are you doing now? Let's have a conversation.
No.
Hey, did
no
go,
I'm going
to
hand it to him. He's going to look up McCain and Bush. Let's see what happens.
Did you go to the governor's inauguration?
Oh, I'm very smartphone stupid. I let my people do that.
Eric, did you go to the state?
You let your people do
yeah,
that?
Yeah, so go ahead,
oh,
Ken.
Oh, excuse me. Guess what? You didn't show up. You go?
What?
Did you go?
No, I didn't want to go.
Shame on you.
There was a
you
lot
didn't
of,
go to...
I seen a lot of Democrats.
I didn't go either.
Okay.
So there we
go. There we go.
All right,
did you go, Eric, to the governor's...
What do you say?
I was sharing with you just
what
before we went on camera.
What is your... What seat? Do you sit on
in the legislature during normal session?
No, we sit in the big room. What's your seat number?
374. When we're in session.
Right, when we're in session. I'm in 383.
All right, okay, so you're all set. You
but
guys
they
would
moved
have
us,
seats.
They moved us around.
No,
for
no,
the,
you
the
would have seats if you wanted it.
I
you
lost mine. No, 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 no.
Seat.
I lost mine.
Why?
They kicked us out because the back rows of all of those sections needed to be filled by staff and other guests.
That's bull.
That's what they
but
did.
But that's the Democrat
if you
way.
Have
that's the big government
seat,
way.
No, that's what they
keep,
did.
No, they take out. They take out like
wait,
five
got
and six.
He got
out.
Kicked out. What don't you understand?
Excuse me.
Listen.
And
to
anyway,
him.
I was.
He was there.
It's 74.
And I didn't care.
You're
it was
not
cool.
Listening to him.
How many seats
can,
did they take?
Ken, rather than beat him, listen to him. The Democrats have no respect. They kicked them out of his seat.
Her Excellency. Her Excellency, and she deserves to be called that because she occupies that seat in that office, had a lot of guests, a lot of staff. There was a lot
there's,
of pomp and circumstance.
There's nothing new about that.
No, there isn't anything new. I'm sure there isn't.
Yeah, can you shut that off?
Look at this. What are you doing?
Mm-hmm. Eric, let's keep talking.
You know, when I start making points,
busy.
He finds a way to,
yes.
to throw me off.
Okay, so
I'm recording
tell
this.
Us. Yeah. So, Eric, that was
this
your first one.
No, it was Ken. I got to tell you, it was a great ceremony. I was proud to be there. The best of New Hampshire was there. I got to tell you, there were some young guys that did the pledge. They did the anthem.
Yeah, I watched it on TV.
There was a young guy, young man who
the
is
scientist.
Blind, as it turns out, and sang the anthem beautifully. Brought me to tears. I was extraordinarily proud to be.
What did you get? Young
to
family,
be a citizen of and a legislator in New Hampshire. Yeah. I got to tell you,
I was impressed with that young scientist.
We're not treated good enough. I got an idea.
I didn't have a problem with her inaugural speech.
I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to him.
That's down. I'm still making my point.
All right, okay. He's not done yet. Let him finish.
No, go ahead.
No.
I was impressed with that young scientist there on the purifier of the water.
Yeah,
unbelievable.
Who was that?
A young lady of Indian descent. Who lives in Nashua?
Yeah,
she attends Nashua North.
And this is your town? You don't even know?
No, Ken, let me tell you about this thing. This is cool.
I'm thinking about Dean Kamen. Dean Kamen does purification of water.
Yeah, this isn't I know about Dean Kamen. No, this is a young lady. She's a teenager. She attends Nashua North. From what I understand.
Okay, speed it up. Come on.
Okay.
So what happened? What did she do?
Well, she and her family went to India. They saw that there was a lot of trouble with dirty water, and this kid came up with a fantastic way to filter the water so that people wouldn't die.
Solar system.
It was using solar power and some filter. I don't know what
some
she used.
Some special filters
cloth.
There, and you didn't need to run electrical
the
down there.
The fact is, she saved a bunch of people.
Right.
And this is a kid.
Well, this is
kid who lives in New Hampshire.
I was very impressed with that. I'm glad I did turn it on here.
It was very touching.
It was the governor's guest, there.
But
was that your first time you went to the governor's?
It was.
It was very impressive.
Very impressive.
This was the first time I missed it.
There were a bunch of people in period garb from Revolutionary
Era.
Presenting the colors, the original colors.
And you have the horsemen there, the governor's, veterans. I can't think what they call them. There's a name for them.
As a veteran, you weren't there?
No, it had nothing to do with that. Being a veteran had nothing to do whatsoever. I didn't want to sit there. I have reasons there with the speaker. I didn't want to watch him make an idiot of himself.
Excuse me, the speaker?
I've got to admit, I got no respect
for the speaker.
The speaker puts you right in the middle because you called him a Democrat.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, the reason why I really love this show now is these Democrats have
Republicans.
The House.
Republicans.
They're acting like Democrats.
Okay,
we're acting like Democrats.
Yeah.
We're not the ones throwing around labels and making big statements shame on you.
Occasionally, I will make an error. This is an error. Yeah. Republicans, not Democrats.
Us Republicans are bad, bad people.
Bad.
We don't want to tax you. We want to live within our means. We want you to protect your Second Amendment rights, free speech.
Yeah, I want you to have personal choice. I want you to have personal liberty.
We're terrible, Republicans.
And they keep talking
about you to have your constitutional
how bad
rights.
Things are and how there is no money and how everybody takes money out of
there
everyone's
he goes
pocket.
Again.
And they're talking about no jobs, but New Hampshire is one of the best states in the United States, and you guys still don't admit it.
Really?
You do not
really,
admit.
Ken? Well, really? Yes. We're not sixth in New England. In terms of business growth.
Will you turn this off, please?
We're not sixth in New England as far as business incubation.
Nowhere in this show do we say how bad New Hampshire is. Because if you asked the question, I would have said because of the Republican, the Senate's budget, the O'Brien budget that was passed that you voted for, the economy is up. Jobs are up.
You know something?
Money coming into the
budget. That was a real turnaround.
Right.
Finally balanced the budget.
That's right.
It looked like we were out of the woods.
Now,
maybe.
Being a freshman.
And now look what's happened in the last 2 years.
Being a freshman, what you're going to be shocked at. You know, even
why?
You,
wait a minute. Whoa. Hold on a second.
Okay. I'm going to show him the courtesy of letting him ask me a rebuttal question.
We have not gotten better in the last 2 years.
Define better.
More money's coming into the state of New Hampshire. More people coming up here. Tourists, more people buying our liquor, more people are using our roads, more people are paying.
I just said that because the senators projected revenues.
Some businesses coming up
here. Your first statement, the answer is no. The other three statements, the answer is yes. Roads, liquor, tourists, yes. Your first statement, no.
Which was taxes, no.
Taxes, no.
Businesses,
business growth, no.
What are you talking about?
Because
I'm talking about people who come up here and they go in and eat.
Taxes.
Is there a tax coming
in? Yeah, but he just agreed with you. He agreed with you. There's
it's
called
Wolf's Tax. If people are coming up, there's more money.
And why do you think I said?
All the guys argue, and they argue. They will not admit
because you stuck in
your arguing with me.
You never admit things are getting better.
That's exactly why I filed a bill to bring even more business, more tourism into this state.
That's right.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah, there you go.
We don't have enough time. No, we'll talk about it another show.
Because the motion picture industry brings a ton of money and a ton of work to every state that they visit.
All right, okay. Besides that, we do have...
It's the truth, folks.
We do have bills that are similar. You make movies. You believe that more people from... do cinema who make movies should come to New Hampshire.
Oh, big time.
After
I
all,
agree
Golden
with
Pawn, that didn't do bad up here.
Yeah, it's been a while, but yes, that's true. That's
you know what my
right.
son
I happen to know that the gentleman, very smart, very talented, still a filmmaker, that made it and directed it, wrote it. I've worked with him in some of his films. And
As an actor?
As an actor, yeah, that's correct.
Well,
and there's a lot of talent in this
state. Why
doesn't
he put his camera up there and do these shows?
Oh, here we go.
Ken,
please,
you know how you can
I don't think he's interested.
You know, ladies and gentlemen, no, I'm not talking about him. I'm talking about, you know why these shows would be good?
What?
He said it. He said it himself. When
because
he was
he's good
block,
at what he does.
All he has to do is call us.
Yeah, no, he said you.
No, I'll call you because you come up with great fiction.
Yeah, that's right. Now, do you know, my son did an intern about 7 years ago here in Nashville. It was a comedy show, and it didn't go off anywhere. But anyways, what he told me was, and he travels around like similar to what you do, but he's not in a movie, does the productions. What he told me is when a movie production comes in, they've got like 75 hotel rooms. They go out to eat. Oh. They spend millions of dollars.
Bring that number up, brother.
Yeah, right. I mean,
you've got livery services. You've got catering. You've got porta potties.
That's right.
The list goes on.
My son told me.
You want to talk about business growth?
This is a no-brainer for New Hampshire.
You want to talk about bolstering the tax base?
I have a bill that is going to, and it would be one part of the creative aspect.
No, it sounds like they actually could work very symbiotically.
No, there's a big difference in his.
There's not a big difference.
There's a big difference. He's taking money from the taxpayer. You're giving a tax break, okay, to bring to get this business to come in. There's a big difference.
Well, how do I take money from the
Because you were talking, the last time you explained the bill to me, you were saying it was...
Yeah, I'd like to read this bill. That's very interesting.
Do you play the guitar?
Because
have you played the guitar?
Listen, we already went through this the last show.
Have you played the guitar?
Listen, no, I don't even want to answer these questions.
You played the guitar.
I don't even want to answer these questions. We went through this the last show. You said they spent $5-6 million, and then I answered you. I said, tell me where the state gets revenue off a ticket. They don't.
Show me what are you talking about?
Are you criticizing his bill?
No, I'm criticizing his bill. His bill is a bunch of BS.
Where does people get money
I
off
see this bill.
Sell a ticket?
There's
are
no
you
tax
trying to
money.
Tell me you go into a theater and you put it down and you buy...
There's not a tax on that ticket.
There's not a tax on that ticket?
The taxpayers don't benefit.
And the people who come up don't stop and get food.
There's a BET,
they don't stop and get
BET
gas.
Tax.
They
what
don't stop
you
and
get?
Go out to eat. They
no,
do nothing.
Wait, that's rooms and meals tax. They do that for everything. That's the rooms and meals. What you don't
are
understand
you
is the breakdown on the money.
Excuse me.
It's literally hiking a tax.
Yes.
Supposedly in order to finance entertainment.
If you have a theater, you have people fixing the theater.
Yes.
You got people acting in the theater.
But the owners are making money.
You got people, the lights,
what don't you understand? The business. Businesses are making money, and they're
already so far. But I got to read this thing.
The businesses are already making money. They're paying a BET and what's it, BPT tax?
We got 2 minutes.
They're
left.
Already paying.
How can we get in touch with you?
Oh goodness gracious! I've got a website.
The film
I've been working on has got a website. I'll just name that one. Spintheplate.com. It's the name of the feature film as well as the book upon which that story is based. You can reach me there. Just go to spintheplate.com. We have a contact us page. I've also got a website, but I won't name that because it's a disaster.
Damn it. Are you on Facebook?
Absolutely.
Facebook.
Eric Robert Eastman.
All right. Twitter.
No.
Okay, you.
I'm on Twitter. I'm on LinkedIn. I have Facebook. I have a website.
Well, they don't know your name. What your name is?
Joe Schmuckatelli. No. Representative Al Baldessaro, www.albaldessaro.com. My phone number is 603-425-6997. Stop by my house in Londonderry. Okay, if you have an issue you want to talk about.
Give the address. I love this.
41 Hall Road, Londonderry, New Hampshire.
I swear I am going to get
a
bus.
That's a lot of faith, Al.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to get a bus. I'm going to fill
you
a
know
bus
something?
Up, and we're going to go
Google's
to Google's
name. Now that you're a legislator, do a Google search here. Your address comes up. Your phone number comes up.
Oh, everything. I know. But believe me, I've been doing it.
So we're an open book now.
And I'd like to give my phone number as well.
All right, tell
them. Hurry
up. Fire.
Okay. Mobile number is, it's a sexy number, 603-400-2022.
You.
How do they get in touch with you? I already gave my number. How do people get in touch with me? They probably don't.
Gidge World. Just go to Gidge World. You don't have to write all of that. Just do Gidge World. You'll find everything you want to know about me, my home telephone number, 603-864-9332. Mr. Eastman, have you had fun?
Indeed, I have.
Hold on. Have you had fun?
You're a worthy adversary.
I wasn't looking
Eric,
at you.
It's a pleasure.
You're a worthy apothecary.
We'll do this again if you had fun. Enjoy. And thank you very much. And believe it or not, we do have fun. And don't take any of this.
And we're friends.
Too serious.
For God's sake, be careful out there.
Goodbye. Thank you.
Happy New Year.
The preceding program was provided by an independent producer solely responsible for its content. The opinions expressed do not necessarily represent the views of this station, its staff, board of directors, or underwriters.